A Baltimore City homeowner claims his house was trashed by renters.
And he's truly surprised because of who his tenant was. 11 News I-Team reporter David Collins investigates.
This is just devastating.
Stephen McFadgen's two-story home in northeast Baltimore was a mess.
It is beyond repair almost. I'm just praying I can recover from this.
McFadgen, a lawyer who lives in Virginia, was renting the place out under Section 8. The rental assistance program for low-income families. When he came to inspect the place last December, he was devastated. He took these pictures of the damage. He says it included trash, feces, roaches, and garbage in an upstairs bathtub. Bedrooms trashed, water damage, and more. He says the color of this carpet used to be gold.
I think I'm in disbelief because of who she was.
His tenant at the time, Shantae Jones, a Section 8 housing inspector in Baltimore City. Her job is to make sure rental units like this are clean and safe. So McFadgen thought it couldn't be in better hands.
My name is Shantae R. Jones.
With her permission, McFadgen used his cell phone to videotape a conversation with Jones back in December. He says she took responsibility for the damage and vowed to make it right.
Give me to January 15th. His house will be in the order that he gave it to me. And also make sure that you get a new tenant.
Jones and her family leased the home through February of this year. McFadgen said she did clean up the trash, but still left plenty of problems.
There's a hole here or something, so be careful right there.
In the kitchen, cabinets are broken, and the sink and stove are filthy. This first floor bathroom is not usable.
The toilet is messed up. There's nothing in the... You can't take a shower, of course, in there.
And there are other problems with the place, but this is where the story becomes a he said, she said.
McFadgen claims Shantae Jones is responsible for the current state of this home and that she strung him along for several months beyond the end of her Section 8 lease, promising to line up contractors to repair the home. They were supposed to do a walkthrough in May, but she didn't show. Shantae Jones could not be reached for comment at her last known address or at her Section 8 office. By phone, she said, "I'll call you back," but didn't.
But according to her bosses at the Housing Authority, Jones's version of the story is she tried several times to get a walkthrough. Not in May, but 2 months earlier, back in March, to get her security deposit back. She says that McFadgen was never available, so she moved on and put the keys in the mailbox. When is not clear.
By that scenario, Housing says anything could have happened to the home after Jones left. McFadgen says he feels duped.
I heard horror stories about tenants staying in homes and messing up a home. I've heard horror stories. But this is a Section 8 employee, and on top of Section 8 employee, it's a Section 8 inspector. Her job is to make sure this doesn't happen to other landlords.
Anthony Scott is deputy director of the City Housing Authority.
If we find that the tenant has done some damage to the house, then we can, in fact, terminate that tenant from our Housing Choice Voucher program.
But the Housing Authority considers this case strictly a landlord-tenant dispute and tells us they will not intervene.
I don't even know how you do that.
McFadgen says his home needs at least $20,000 in repairs just to be able to rent it again.
If I can't meet this financial demand on me right now, I might lose the home. And that's something I do not want to happen.
But to recoup anything, he'll have to prove in court Jones is responsible. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm David Collins.